She said it was just a figment of speech. And I said, do you mean figure? And she said, no, figment, because she could never imagine it happening. But it did. When we first met, I played the shy boy. And when she spoke to me for the very first time, my nose began to bleed. She guessed the rest. The next day, when we went on a bus ride to the ferry and nobody came to collect our fares, well, I knew this was something really special. I couldn't stop thinking about her, and every time I turned on the radio, there was someone else singing about the two of us. It was like being on a fast ride at a funfair, the sort that is too fast, you're scared, you want to get off, and when you're off, you want to get straight back on again. But our love is strange, ladies and gentlemen, and sometimes you have to take the crunchy with the smooth. She started going out with Mr. Potato Head. Yeah. It was when I saw her in the car park with his coat around her shoulders that I realised. I went home and thought about the two of them together while the bathwater went cold around me. I thought about her eyes and the curve of her breasts and the point where their bodies met. I confronted her about it. I said, I'm the most illegible bachelor in town. And she said, yeah. That's why I can never understand any of those stupid letters you send me. And then one day it happened. She voted Tory and I stopped loving her.